Deputy Roisin Shortall, please.
Cian Corlea. Taoiseach, we learned from media reports this morning that you and your government are considering holding 8 different referenda within the next 2 years. These range from important things like repealing the Eighth Amendment to changing the law on blasphemy to things like reducing the age of voting to 16. There is one glaringly obvious and desperately needed omission from that list, Taoiseach, and that is a commitment to amend the Constitution in respect of Article 43. Now, Article 43, as you know, acknowledges a natural right to private property above any human-made law. It goes on to state that this right must be regulated by the principles of social justice, and that on occasion such rights require to be delimited by the exigencies of the common good. Now, notwithstanding those safeguards, regrettably the superior courts have consistently taken the most narrow view of Article 43 when the exercise of property rights is deemed to be detrimental to the common good. In the main, the courts have found in favour of upholding private property rights, or else they have ruled that the state must pay prohibitive levels of compensation. The impact of Article 43 has been most profound and most detrimental in respect of the provision of housing. Successive ministers for housing, Taoiseach, have claimed that Article 43 significantly restricts the capacity of government to introduce key measures to deal with the housing crisis. So things like, for example, the imposition of a meaningful vacant site levy to address the pressing issue of land hoarding, and not just, you know, the meagre little levy that's promised to kick in at some point that is far lower than the inflation rate of vacant land. Measures to tackle the large number of vacant properties, for example. Measures to prevent the eviction of families in cases where a landlord is selling a property. And attempts to implement compulsory purchase orders in respect of unused housing land banks. So while there are major problems regarding housing and housing land leading to a crisis of affordability and supply, it seems that there is no appetite on the part of government to remove the constitutional obstacle that is Article 43. Taoiseach, how on earth is amending Article 43 of the Constitution not on your priority list for a referendum? Without it, how can we achieve social justice and serve the common good in respect of housing? Will you now, Taoiseach, commit to an early referendum on Article 43 so that the housing crisis can be tackled comprehensively and effectively, and that we get no more excuses from government ministers?
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
The priority list set out by government today, or agreed by government today, creates indicative timelines for future referendums. The referendums that very much flow from the Citizens' Assembly. The Citizens' Assembly did make a recommendation in relation to economic, social and cultural rights, and I understand that, that as well as a proposal on housing has been referred for further consideration to the Department of Finance. The proposal, or at least the indicative proposal, is to have a standalone referendum on the Eighth Amendment in May or June next year. And we'll very much, that'll very much follow on from the recommendations of the All-Party Committee, which is considering the matter, and they have a deadline to report by Christmas. Further referendums to be held concurrent with the presidential election, whether or not there is one, in winter of 2018, dealing with women in the home, blasphemy, and the possibility of plebiscites on directly elected mayors. And then in summer 2019, concurrent with the local and European elections, referendums to extend the franchise to citizens abroad to vote in presidential elections, and also liberalising our divorce laws on foot of Deputy Madigan's bill. In terms of property rights, I have to say I dislike the term property rights. It implies that properties have rights. Properties don't have rights, individuals have rights. So if you own a farm, you have a certain right to deal with that farm and manage that farm and do what you like with it. If you have a business, you have certain rights over your business. If you have a home, you have a right to live in it. And of course, if you have an investment property and it's your pension, you have certain rights to it too. So I think when we talk about diluting or removing property rights, we shouldn't make the mistake of thinking we're removing rights from properties. We're removing rights from people. And I'd like to understand better that those who wish, when those who advocate diluting those rights, exactly which individual rights they want to take away from which individual people, specifically what and why. But I actually think sometimes the restriction on property rights or the protection of property rights in the Constitution can actually be over-egged. We do have a vacant site levy. We did bring that in, notwithstanding property rights. That is in place now. We've brought in the rent pressure zones, putting caps on rent increases. Again, some people said that was a violation of property rights. It turned out it wasn't. And also, it is the case that local authorities can use CPOs to CPO vacant properties. In fact, Louth County Council has done that now on dozens of occasions. So actually, people often hold up property rights as an excuse for things not being done. But we've found now on a number of occasions that actually we can do those things without breaching property rights.
Of people who have property and not the rights of other people who are on the housing waiting list, who are homeless and so on. You know, you'd have to ask, how many homeless people does it take for you to recognise the obstacle that is Article 43? It is most profound, obviously, in relation to housing. And you clearly are not listening to the points that are made very strongly by your present Minister for Housing and previous Ministers for Housing in respect of the obstacle that for Article 43 has put in their way. Look, in addition to the whole area of housing, Article 43 has been a long-standing impediment to fair and balanced legislation in a whole lot of different areas. For example, we know that in 1996, the Supreme Court ruled that Employment Equality Bill was unconstitutional because it put too much of a cost burden on employers. We know that the risk of unconstitutionality was also cited as the reason why the last government reneged on its promise to abolish upward-only rent reviews. We know that in this government, Minister Nocton has also indicated that Article 43 is an impediment to legislating to address the over-concentration of media ownership in this country.
Thank you, Deputy.
For all of these reasons, but particularly in relation to the housing crisis, I ask you, Taoiseach, to reconsider your priorities and commit to a referendum to amend Article 43 of the Constitution.
Taoiseach, to conclude, please.
I think, Deputy, there's a difference between not listening and not agreeing. I am listening. That's not necessarily the same thing as agreeing. As I've already said, we've on a number of occasions now considered the balance of property rights and the public interest. Property rights in Ireland are not exclusive. They're not without limitation. They are limited by the public interest. And we have used that public interest test to bring in rent caps, which have kept rents down in large parts of the country. CPOs are used regularly to CPO land for everything from housing to roads. And also we've brought in the vacant sites levy. But certainly if the Deputy has a specific proposal, wording that she wants to introduce into the Constitution, this government does not have a majority in the stall. It is absolutely open to her to bring that proposal to the floor and to have a vote on it in this House.
Thank you, Taoiseach.